slide with it, slide with it, now glide with it, now work, 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 now slide with it.
I'm one of three owners of Amiti Accessories. This is Ntesi and this is Nguile, my two best friends who are also the owners of Amiti Accessories. So basically, Amiti Accessories is an accessory business where we sell a wide range of accessories for both men and women at affordable prices. And today I'm just going to be walking you guys through the process and how things go when it comes to delivering and packaging orders. So you guys can just get a look at how it is being a business owner at 17 and how it is. In the end of this video, I'll be answering a few questions that I get a lot, like a lot. So yeah, stay tuned. I'm done picking the orders, I have them right here, and I live close to an Aramex drop box spot thingy, so I'm gonna go there, drop these packages off, and yeah, I don't have a car and I don't wanna school, so I'm gonna walk away and you guys will just see me when you get there and just see how it goes when I get there.
Pay and bought a few Aramex sleeves, and as you can see here, I'm putting one of the orders in the Aramex sleeve and sealing it. Here I was looking for a pen so I could fill in the way bill with the information of the customer as well as my information in case the package gets lost or they can't find the address of the customer. When filling in these papers, you need to fill in four different papers, as you can see here. One for the customer, one for me, and the other two for the delivery person. In this clip, I was going to drop the packages off into the Aramex drop box, where the delivery person will fetch them at 3 o'clock that day, and if I came later than 3 o'clock, then 3 o'clock the following day. They will then deliver it to the destination. So I decided decided not to film this part of the video and instead just put text of our answers, because since there are three owners, it's only fair for all three of us to answer the questions.
Hello everyone, my name is Kabelo Mapeto. I'm based in Polokwane and I sell bags. The reason why I started selling bags is because due to the shortage of jobs in South Africa as a whole, I decided that I want to do something that can manufacture, that can make me money, generate me money. And because finding a job is not that easy, no matter you come from a university, no matter what not. So I decided to do something that I like and make it make money for me. So I decided to sell bags. As you can see, I love bags. I really, really love bags. So I decided to, a girl can never have enough bags. So yeah, that's why I'm selling bags. The name of my company is The Chic Capsule. Chic obviously meaning a girl. The, just to emphasize everything else. Then The Capsule. I just took it from the, I assume we all know what a time capsule is, because since a time capsule captures moments, like getting, it captures bags according to the to each generation as we progress. Yeah, so that's why I decided to call it the Chic Capsule. One thing that I can tell you if other people is, if you want to say something and you're passionate about it, please do it. No matter what, if you have the means and the capability of doing it, do it. I don't have any business background or whatsoever, but I just decided to do it because I love bags and I love money. Why not? So yeah, that's why I did what I did. And I, don't be afraid to start something that you like. Like, don't be afraid to do it. Just do it. Go for it. Yeah, man, just to motivate other girls, other people out there, just secure that bag, man. So for anyone who wants more information about my business, or for anyone who's interested in buying a bag, you can contact me. I don't have an Instagram account yet. I'm new and I'm not yet established on Instagram. So if you want to contact me, you can contact me on my Facebook. I created a Facebook account for the bags, so you can contact me on Facebook. Either you can go to my page, my personal page is Kabelo Innocentia Mapeto. Then the page that I created for the bags is the Chic Capsule. Yes, just like that. And yeah, thank you.
My name is Nikom Tileni and I am the chairperson of Hinyanza Yungwe. Hinyanza Yungwe is a charity drive founded by six girls from Kanyisa Education Center, which is located in the outskirts of Giyani. We are a charity drive that focuses mainly on the lack of sanitary pads for schoolgirls in and around our communities. We also focus on the empowerment of young women so that they grow to be women of knowledge and wisdom. May be asking themselves what Inyanza Yingwe means and what language it is. Inyanza Yingwe is a Tsonga phrase meaning that we are one. In this, the charity drive encourages unity amongst women of all ages. Every other charity drive in the world, we have a vision, we have a mission, and we have objectives. Our slogan is making a better tomorrow today. Our vision is to have a great generation of women who will change the status quo of today's and tomorrow's society. Our mission is to touch the beautiful souls of our community and to offer a helping hand where we can. To help underprivileged girls feel comfortable during their menstrual cycle and to keep them in school regardless. It is also to break the stigma around menstruation. Our goals for 2021 are big. When I say big, I mean big. we want to donate sanitary pads to as many schools as we can. While our goals for 2021 are big. When I say big, I mean big. We want to donate sanitary pads to as many schools as we can while being helped by you guys, the public at large. We are aiming at advocating the government to make sanitary pads free at clinics and hospitals, tax-free at retail stores. One of our biggest goals for 2021 is to host an awareness event that is centered on breaking the stigma surrounding menstruation and mental health. We'll be collaborating with various organizations and brands like Mental Health Mentors, The Movement, shout out to you guys, Shali Cares, shout out, Elusive, and many more brands, shout out to Elusive and the other brands we're working with. To make this event a success, we'll need your support in all forms that you can think of. We need support on social media platforms, we need support financially and in any other way possible. Remember, we are non-profit. We are not an organization, we are a charity drive, but still, we are non-profit. Yes. Then we will have speakers from Nyanza Yingwe and Mental Health Matters. We'll also have a lineup of local artists that will be performing support financially and in any other way possible. Remember, we are non-profit. We are not an organization, we are a charity drive, but still, we are non-profit. Yes. We'll have speakers from Nyanza Yingwe and Mental Health Matters. We'll also have a lineup of local artists that will be performing their amazing songs on empowerment, on mental health matters, and on anything. Like, it will be fire, guys. It will be flames. And also, we're also having brands come over and advertise their merchandise and stuff like that. Yeah. So it will be fun. It will be a fun-filled event. I promise. Any announcements or statements will be released on our social media platforms, so stay in touch. If you'd like to donate sanitary pads, cash, any other items or services, please contact us on Instagram at Nyanza Yingwe, Twitter at Nyanza, WhatsApp or call at 082-936-5027 or email us at info.nyanzayingwe@gmail.com. Shout out to Sipe Matavata for giving us a platform to talk about our charity drive and get it out there, man.
Hi everyone, I'm Masha Sabiwa and I recently turned 16 on the 11th of June. I just want to say thank you so much to Sipe for giving me this opportunity of promoting myself and what I do, what I love doing. So really, thank you so much, Sipe. What you're doing is very great for young girls out there. It's really motivating us and encouraging us to just do more, to not be afraid of showing our talents and what we do. So as you can see in the background, some artwork. And yes, I did all of these. I just want to quickly explain my whole art journey and how it began. I was, I think, 7 years old when I realized that I can paint. Well, I'm a talented artist. I was 7 years old and I realized that. So basically, I started off by drawing on a chalkboard. My mom bought me these little chalkboards, so that's where I started drawing. And my parents were very, very, very surprised with the outcome. That's when I decided that, okay, let me take this to another level and I want to try painting, because I only used to sketch on canvas paper. And then I decided that I want to try painting. So I started off by going and buying, you know, like cheap canvas, cheap paints, and just seeing how everything goes. before I actually get into it and actually invest some money into art, because these art is just expensive, like, in general. So yeah, so I just want to show you guys my very first paintings that I tried out. This one is from 2018 and this one is also from 2018. And this one was actually my very first, like, proper tryout, because I was trying to pull off a sunset with clouds, because my cousin asked me to do that. As you can see, his name up there. But yes, I tried, and I think it wasn't bad. It wasn't that bad. It was also not as good as I thought. And it's also a 2018 painting, so this is actually my very first, and then these ones came, right? So yeah, and then I started on going bigger, looking for more challenging artwork to do on Pinterest and all of that, and everything is just great right now. Like, I perfected my skill by myself, you know, without any tutoring or anything like that. Not necessarily sitting down and saying that, okay, I'm practicing now and I am trying to be better, I'm trying to improve. It just happened naturally when I just continued painting. So, like, after this one, I went on to painting an elephant. It turned out great, and I painted another elephant. And so far, I've painted like 4 elephants. Like, I really enjoy painting elephants, even though it's not even close to being my favorite animal. But yes, and then yeah, so far, I'm working on a sunset, and I'd like to show you guys a sneak peek on the beginning of it. And I'm also working on Goku, and I did a drawing of my father and a lion. I'm still working on those, so let me just show you guys how they turned out. So this is the one that I was talking about, of my dad. I only drew it so far because I'm really scared. Like, I don't know what's gonna happen if I try to put paint here, and I don't want to damage it. So I don't know what I'm waiting for, if I'm being honest, but I'm just scared to ruin the whole thing, so I'm not gonna paint it for now. And then this is the one of Goku that I was speaking about, which I am painting for my cousin, my little cousin. Yeah, I think it's going great so far, but I'm going to post the end result soon for this one. And then this is the lion that I was talking about. I just drew it, I'm still gonna paint it. And this is the sunset. I know it pretty much looks complete, but it's not. I'm still going to add a few things, and I'm also gonna be posting it soon. This is probably the biggest sized canvas that I've ever painted on. So I think, yeah, I'm quite happy with how it's going so far, because I was very afraid in the beginning. And then this one, actually, I don't even know, like, which way is the right way, because if I'm being honest, like, I just said, okay, let's see how it goes, let's just put paints, let's just splash everything and make something great. And this is how it turned out. I really did not even know what I was doing on that day. I just felt, okay, let's make something work, let's make something work. And this is how it turned out. So you can literally look at it from this way, like this, like whichever way, because there is really no, there's nothing with this. Okay, yeah, that's basically all that I have to show today. I've only sold my artwork to my family members and wrapped it as a birthday gift to my friends or to my family members. But soon I'm going to be selling it to the public, because people have been asking me how much my art costs, am I selling? Like, they've been really showing interest in my work. And in the beginning, it was never a plan to do this as a business. You know, I was just painting for fun. The modeling account is at w.ashuu, and my other Instagram account is Tlabiwa Artist, and on Facebook My name is Washi Khabiwa. So yes, please follow me on all platforms and just see what I do in modeling, my life in general, my art, and yes, the voting details are on my modeling account at model_washu_Khabiwa. Yes, that's where you're gonna find all the details about this pageant. And I really like your support. Like, please vote for me. Please vote for me. Continue voting for me if you've already voted for me. And I really appreciate the love and support. And yes, thank you so much. And I really hope that you'll just support what I do.